Welcome back to Los Santos. This time we're in Del Perro Pier, which sounds an awful lot like that soccer player Del Piero, who plays for God knows what team anymore because I don't follow football anymore. But they're all a bunch of pansies, really, just diving on the ground. It's not what it used to be, that's for sure. Anyways, let's go over and start this mission with Lester. There's some really nice cars over here in the car park as well. So, anyways, I'll be uploading hopefully a good amount of episodes this weekend. I'm assuming about at least 3 or 4 on both weekend days, both the Saturday and Sunday. Maybe even the Monday, because Monday in Australia is like Sunday in America and the rest of the world, because after all, we do live in the future. Let's see what Lester's got to say for himself, though.
What's up, man?
Sit down and face forward. Now, I don't have a lot of time. I know you need money. Did Michael tell you about Life Invader?
Oh, shit. Y'all two did that?
Look forward. We're two strangers having a friendly chat. And don't pretend that you liked Jane Norris.
Oh, man, I don't know, homie. I mean, yeah, the dude outsourced work to child slaves. Then stole and sold everybody's private information. And even ripped his own friends' ideas off and walked around like the Messiah while doing it, but... Man, I don't think the nigga deserved to have his fucking head blowed off on TV.
Oh, well, aren't you just a moral majority? You know, that's why the world is the way it is today, when a paid thug gets all namby-pamby when someone asks him to act like a paid thug and for a good cause.
Man, check this out, homie. I like blowing motherfucking fools' heads off just as much as the next psychotic asshole. But I just don't look at the shit as doing a good deed.
Well, now you can, because it's not fools' heads, it's assholes' heads. And not just heads, you know, trashing cars or planting lies, forging evidence, anything we can do to take the battle back to these turds. You know, we'll fix the market in our favor and we'll right a few wrongs while we're at it.
Shit, okay, cool.
Right, so, you heard of Mollus?
Hell yeah.
Okay, so there's a new mollus, sort of a super mollus, and it's called Priapulse. It's giving the living rigor mortis. Only Brett Lowry, CEO of Bilkington Research, paid off the FDA. And he doesn't care that his hardness pills are giving desperate middle-aged men the world over heart attacks.
Damn, man, that sucks.
Yeah, it does. Now, Mr. Greedy Lowry is staying at the Von Krastenberg Hotel in Richmond. Of course, he'll be well protected, but if he goes away, then America goes back to using mollus, and Beta Pharmaceuticals gets a big bump in the price of their stock.
Damn, man. All right. Fuck it. I got you.
I thought that you would. Now, consider using a sniper rifle or sticky bombs. You know, whatever. Do it your way, however you want. I'm gonna make the investment. We don't speak about this or anything. Now walk away, and I'll stay here till you're gone.
Okay, I'll be keeping an eye out on you. So I'm gonna go to the hotel. Gonna find a car. We might as well just take our motorbike that we drove up here with. Pizza for $1.99, a cheese slice. That was a ripoff. $1.99 for a slice of pizza.
Under the age of 45 and now have a tattoo, but most are ignorant egomaniacs with no real sense of.
That car looks so much better than a motorbike. And after all, with motorbikes, you can pretty much kill yourself if you don't drive too well. Thankfully, the hotel doesn't seem to be that far away. Hope if that guy didn't just barge in front of us. What's this? This is Richard's Majestic. That's like the movie studios, stage 13, 14. That's pretty cool. What's it say over here? Vinewood Zombie. Let's go out over this way, though. The hell is that bus doing? I think he's trying to do a U-turn or something of that sort, and we went completely the wrong way. We need to go around this way, where that bus was. Alright, hopefully that bus hasn't completely blocked us off. What the hell is the bus thinking it's doing? Alright, so we're going to go up in the car park. Let's just make sure I have a sniper rifle. I do. Okay. That's a relief. So I guess we're going to get to the top of the... Maybe? No? It's not pointing up, so we might as well just have to go around here. There we go, on the other side. Right, guards have arrived to pick up the target from the hotel. He's expected to leave very soon. Plan the attack quickly to find a location with a good vantage point of the hotel. Alright, so where are we now? He's checking out in a minute and a half. So what we're going to do, of course, is with that time, we're going to go right to the top over here, which I think makes the most sense. Although, of course, they're going to know that we're up here, though. So it's going to be a little bit difficult to escape, I'm assuming. Have to try our best, though. Better start. Okay, we're already at the top. That's good. Don't need to worry about too much. Let's just scope out over here. Okay. There we go. This is a perfect vantage.
Let's move it out, people! Oh, we need this area cleared!
Problem is, though, we can't climb up here. A little bit difficult to see. Where is he checking out from? It's quite difficult to see from here. What if I did this? There we go. Just gonna make sure we don't kill ourselves. Right, here he goes. He's coming out. Two, one. Assassinate the target. I think the tree might be in the way, but no. Shit. Come on. What? No. You're kidding me. Alright, well, they saw us, obviously. I wonder what's going to happen now. I can't believe they shot us as well. That quickly. That's pretty interesting. Okay, let's give it one more shot. There's no doubt we're going to get it this time, though. Still. Where's the car? Right over here. It's parked properly now. It's like they're cool with us just doing it over here. Seems like I'll be able to clear him out pretty simply over here. And we should be able to get out. The escape, I think, is over that way. Pretty sure it is, anyway. That's the way I'm going to drive out. Let's just stay around here then. Yeah, I don't have any satchel charges either. Okay. Maybe we could try sniping once again. Gotta wait a whole nother minute though. What other ways are there that you can do it? Maybe get your own car, satchel charge it up, and then detonate it when he walks by. Like a car bomb. Instead of chucking the satchel charges on his car.
Let's move it out, people! We need this area cleared!
Alright. Gonna be coming out. See some action happening over here. There we go. Here come the security guards. If I don't get this one more time, this is gonna be an absolute fail. Where are the guards? They can't see us, which is a good thing. Alright, I figured out what that red dot or red line means. It means the zoom in level. Alright. Here is the target.
Man, you get what you give out, Mr. Lowry.
Let's leave the area. They haven't killed us yet. Surprisingly. And I missed him the first time as well, which is quite sad, really. That's typical of me, though. Now, I think over here on the left is escape route. Here we go, let's go out this way. I think we made it out alive and perfectly fine this time. Seems like it anyway. There we go, mission passed. How did we get gold then? Okay. Also earned a nice bit of money as well. Not quite sure how that worked out in our favor in the end, because I did fail that mission pretty badly. Alright, so where are we going to now? Let's go get this phone call out of the way.
Hey, it's done.
I know. Good work.
All right, well, shit. Let me know about the next thing.
Will do. But before that, I've got to tell you something. Our investment portfolio is getting a little, successful, so I figured we needed some tangible assets and property. So we bought a house in the Vinewood Hills.
Yeah, sure, man. Whatever. You know best about this shit.
And we needed someone to live there for tax purposes, so some guys are moving your stuff in.
Oh, shit! Meaning I don't have to live with my crazy-ass aunt no more? Man, I don't know what the fuck to say, dawg.
Don't say anything, especially if a man in a suit comes to the door. Ah, I'm joking. That probably isn't gonna happen. It's yours. Enjoy it. 3671 Wispy Mound Drive.
Wispy Mountain Drive. That is a pretty fantastic sounding place. Let's find out where it is, though. Okay. It says assassination. Another mission. Okay. Leicester. Anyways, let's go to this. Franklin has been moved into a new house in Vinewood Hills. This location can now be used to save progress and change clothes. Cool stuff. Actions in the world may have an impact on company stock. Values take advantage of likely changes in stock prices to generate extra capital.
Hey, Mike.
Hey, I spoke to Steve. We're ready to move. I gotta take the loot to this guy me and Trevor met, Devin Weston. Big time investor or something.
Oh, all right, shit. Well, I'll see you at the lot.
Let's go do this a little bit later on, though. Let's firstly do the Leicester mission. I'm assuming this isn't going to be my house. It's not in Vinewood Hills, I don't think. Definitely doesn't seem like Vinewood Hills. Where are we off to now? That's a nice looking car. There's someone taking a photo of it as well. All right, let's just casually run around with that sniper rifle into this limited gasoline place.
Always 5 minutes before I go home.
No, 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 I'm not robbing you, mate. You're all good. I'm gonna go in this way. There we go. That's the payphone. That's
okay. You know Redwood cigarettes?
Sure, the cigarette that built America.
They've rigged a jury to throw a class action lawsuit that would cover the treatment costs of thousands of emphysema sufferers. There are 4 corrupt jurors on Redwood's books. I'll send you the details. Oh, and we only have a few hours to make them disappear. The court case is tomorrow morning.
Is that all, dog? Shit, that's quite a favor.
And that's quite a house you're living in. Get this done quickly, and I'll try to throw in a sweetener as well. Now, I'd advise picking up some long-range hardware to get this job done. You'll be helping a lot of people with this, Franklin, including anyone who might have a sizable investment in, say, debonair cigarettes.
Okay, Vespucci Beach. Bodybuilder, Muscle Sands, delete this message. What? What's that got to do with anything, mate? Actually, no, let's not call him up. Let's go over to where we need to go. Take out the juror. There's an ammunition, which is placed perfectly right next to where we start this mission off. So obviously that's there for a reason. Let's go over there. Not worry about the juror. All targets must be eliminated in the time given. Okay. Let's see. What do you have to offer me? A heavy sniper rifle. That seems quite good. How much would it cost? Might as well get 12 rounds.
Well, the breakdown of society is
inevitable. So I've already got it. Minigun, can't get it. Can get a grenade launcher, so I'll get that. And upgrade that. And the RPG. With the army tins. Beautiful. That's good enough for now. I don't really want any armor either, because I don't think we'll really need it. After all, they're only jurors, so they should be pretty much civilians. Unless Lester's really screwed us over this time. Wouldn't put it past him. This car is mighty quick. There's a one weird turn off as well. It's almost like we're going over into Trevor's cousin's house. Oh god, this does not seem promising. Okay, he's right over here. Oh, so he's the Oh, wow, this is Muscle Beach. Very cool. That is pretty sweet. Alright, so I guess this is the guy we gotta kill.
I think I saw you.
He ain't dead yet? want to lay down. Here we go. Ain't nothing personal. A north yacht off the coast of Pacific Bluff. Sneak pipeline in. Take out another juror. That was an interesting juror, though. That was pretty sweet, though, Muscle Beach. With the lady taking photos of the bodybuilder, she's probably got video evidence of us killing him, but oh well. It's not like it's gonna make much of a difference.
Let's stop and cool down for a second while we hear some commercials, damn it.
Yeah, damn it, let's hear some commercials. Let's change the station, maybe. So, there we go. Some nice Jamaican Rastafari music. Oh, we go. This is the place where the Azerbaijani was, wasn't it? Looks a lot like it. It's definitely where we started the game off, though. It's good that I'm starting to memorize the map now. It is quite large, though, so pretty proud of the fact that we are doing as well as we are. All right, now I know why it told us to delete these texts. Except I don't know how. Okay. Just press X, I think. Now, this guy's on the yacht. Shouldn't be too hard to kill him. I'm here. Wonder what he looks like, though. There's probably a couple of guys here. I think it's the guy. He's got a prostitute with him. Problems with that lady. She might have got it caught up there as well. Get to west of Vinewood fast. Eclipse Medical Tower. Look for dirty windows. All right. Supposedly this game is going to be coming out on the Xbox 360 and the PS3 as well, which the hell just happened?
Damn, I ain't got much time left.
Yeah, we do. We haven't even gone through half the time, have we? Pretty sure we haven't. In that time, I managed to get through ammunition and all that. With an RPG, I've got like a good amount of weaponry. Nothing really to worry about there. See how the front of the car is doing. Not too bad. Casually up some hills. That guy was driving on the wrong side of the road. Come on, mate. It was not my fault at all. Dirty windows, you say? Well, they all seem to have like a crappy JPEG image on them. What am I supposed to be looking at here, folks? Eclipse, look for dirty windows. Get out of here. Which building is this? Is it this one? Yeah, it seems like it is. Here we go. Now I see what they mean. Ouch. Alright, any GPS now? Bike at Vinewood Hills, look for a batty bike. We've got to move, Franklin. We definitely have to move. We've got 2 minutes to cover a mile. Just a bit over a mile and a third. I think we'll manage to do it just in time. Well, we'll be pressed. Thankfully, we've got a nice fast car. This is definitely going to be the last juror that we need to kill because I think there were four, so. This is obviously the fourth one. Decided to challenge us a bit though. I'll come the distance pretty quickly. After all, I do drive like a bit of a lunatic. I love the changing moon cycles. It's just such a massive amount of detail into the game. Alright, and he seems like he's not driving at all. Seems like he's just standing by. Here we go. Oh no, there, okay, that's him. Let's just drive him over then.
Look out the way!
That ought to do it, I would say as well. He's definitely dead. Poor guy.
Hey, L, it's done, homie. All of them.
Very good. I'll be in touch.
Alright, that's great news. You be in touch. Time taken 7 minutes 32. That was another 100% mission. Bit of a surprise. I thought I've been doing bad over the last couple of missions, but it doesn't seem to be the case. I'm not sure if that was a good idea, because there's houses over here. We're going to be driving through someone's backyard, unless we go up on this little rocky outcrop and just hope for the best. Like that. Right. Now, we've got this H mission, which I'm assuming that's the heist. Yeah, Federal Investigation Bureau heist. So, we might as well go ahead and drive there, but I don't think I will start this episode. Yet another heist. Man, we better be making a good amount of money soon, though. Let's see who's got how many missions. All right. Trevor's still got 6. A fair bit. Oh, that's one way to drive. Go around this way. Oh, here we go. Got to jump around here. It's going to be good. Oh, Jesus Christ. It just keeps on going down and down and down. Because Danny. Alrighty. That is a huge jump. Wow. Alright. That's a lot of fun. 411 feet. And it cut down a fair amount of distance as well, it seems like. Off our little trek that we've got to do to the FIB mission. Let's just drive over there, see if anyone's going to call us up on the way. I doubt they will. That's a nice looking carpet. Might as well stick with the Corvette. Whatever. It seems like it says Cockettes. Yeah, Cockettes on the Corvette that we're driving. It's hard to see though, because after all, we did damage the car pretty badly. Like so. What is it with this classical music? Let's go with Window Licker. Interesting name for a song. I guess it's rather appropriate after we killed that guy on the window cleaning machine. Oh, what the hell just happened? The game pretty much just crashed. It just stopped for a good amount of time. I thought the game exploded almost. But off we go, onto the right. Is that the right way? It seems like it was. I'm hoping it was. If it wasn't, well, done goofed. There we go, and just keep on going forward past this little cement truck. I don't know why, but this highway really reminds me of Need for Speed for whatever reason. Need for Speed open world games, they were amazing. Oh, and there we go, we actually upgraded our driving abilities, because I guess we are slaloming between all these vehicles. I'm pretty sure Franklin's got really good driving abilities in comparison to the rest of the characters though, because it is Franklin. Probably drives out, pimps out cars in his free time. Where are we off to now? Around the back. Interesting. That is going to be it for another episode. We'll be back very shortly with the beginning of the FIB investigation thing.